the half hour before the Derby. Speaking of ends of the spectrum.
Well, it was just the craziest half hour you could ever imagine. I mean, we were, I actually walked over with 1,000 words because of the Albaugh's, and they were in town. They're our partner on that horse. We bought it together as a yearling. So I knew that my racehorse, their representatives were walking over with Authentic. So walk over and then, you know, to see the horse in the paddock. He didn't want to be saddled. I feel terrible for Jimmy. You know, when the horse flipped over, you know, Jimmy had to have 9 screws put in his arm and putting him back together. And of course, you're just sad that you don't get a chance, you know, 20 minutes before the Derby for a chance to be able to run. I'm going to pull this down a second here. And it was just heartbreaking. And, you know, you're in the paddock, you're a little bit stunned at that point that that happened. I remember everybody was just kind of in a fog, but as we walked through the tunnel out onto the track, I told our general manager, Ned Toffee, I said, you know, if there's any Derby gods looking down upon us after 1,000 words flipping, maybe it'll give Authentic a little push around there and get us to the winner's circle. And boy, I tell you what, it sure did.
When you were watching the races, the horses were turning for home, and Tis the Law, you know, sort of collars him. And I know the people that had Mr. Big News were thinking, yeah, these fractions were fast. All right, we got a chance to win. What are you thinking then?
Well,
what were you thinking like at the end point?
No doubt. I mean, when I saw the opening fractions of 22 and change, I was very, very worried. And, you know, knowing that you've got to go a mile and a quarter and pace that was on and you're right, certainly as they turn for home, you know, I saw Manny Franco look over his right shoulder. And so I thought, boy, you know, he's really loaded on Tis the Law. And you hear the announcer giving the big call for Mr. Big News, and he's just rolling around horses there on the outside. And so, you know, you're just at that point, you know, looking to see how much fight you got left in you down the stretch. And, you know, really in the back of my mind, I'm thinking, you know, can we just hang on here to hit the board? And when turned for home and Johnny hit him left-handed, then he just came, you know, gave so much effort down the stretch and just kept giving more and more to Johnny. And, you know, it was just such a thrill to go from being so depressed in the paddock with what happened with 1,000 words to seeing Authentic win. It was just the biggest rocket ship of emotion in that 20 minutes there that you could ever imagine. And then just the thinking of Mr. Hughes and all he's meant to all of our team at Spendthrift, and seeing that, you know, he was able to win that elusive Kentucky Derby was just as good as it gets.
Yeah, because Spendthrift has certainly been connected through stallions to the, you had Orb, you know, that Malibu
That was by
Moon.
Malibu Moon,
yeah.
Yes, ma'am.
Have you had anybody else since Orb between them?
No, that's been it. That's been it.
The difference between having the stallion, which is great, but having the stallion and the, because Authentic isn't Into Mischief, right?
Yes, he is.
Yeah, having the stallion and the horse.
That was the whole combination, no doubt about it, Jeannie. That was fantastic, and, you know, it's what it's done for Into Mischief out at the sale. That was kind of the missing link, is people questioned whether he could have a horse win a classic. And now that he checked that box off, you know, it's just been on out here on the sale, and it's been so great to see. I mean, it wasn't that too long ago. I'm looking back at some averages there that someone had in a publication the other day, and it wasn't very many years ago, he was averaging $21,000 per yearling. And after the first two books, he's averaging $500,000 now. So Into Mischief, it just climbed the ladder of stallion success, and it's just put him in a whole nother stratosphere now.
Did you have any question about Authentic going a mile and a quarter before he did it?
Well, I think we're all kind of programmed in the back of our mind, because so many people have said, well, the Into Mischief, phenomenal sire, but probably not going to get a classic distance. And so, you know, even though we stand the stallion and we're every day out there pitching these horses to breeders and everything else, you can't help but, until it's done, to even question your own mind if they can do it. And for him to be able to do that, you know, was just amazing. And, you know, with Authentic, when we bought him, you know, we knew he had the talent, but he also had a little bit of a different build than a lot of the Into Mischiefs. He was leggier, scopier, stretchier type. And what's happened is as the stud fees have gone up, commercial breeders and breeders alike have gone out here and bred more of a stretchy type mare to him. And so you're starting to see more leggy Into Mischiefs. And, you know, we felt like with these top class mares, they're starting to get, you know, his way, that we felt like there was certainly a shot that there would be a classic horse come along, and thank goodness it was Authentic.